Hi, my name is Meredith Strahan, and I'm the Governor's STEM Academy Coordinator at Grassfield High School. As you will see, STEM stands for Science, Technology, Engineering, and Mathematics. But at the Governor's STEM Academy, the E in STEM also stands for entrepreneurship, because many of the entrepreneurs of today, and certainly tomorrow, are engineers and software programmers. Technology is the underlying factor of every aspect of our lives, and technology is advancing at an exponential rate. Therefore, the demand for people in technology fields is more than significant. It's important that we are preparing for that today. Think about it. The top 10 in-demand jobs today did not exist in 2010. We are currently preparing students for jobs that don't yet exist, using technologies that haven't been invented. In order to solve problems we don't even know are problems yet. 65% of the jobs in 2030 have not been invented, but at the Governor's STEM Academy, we are preparing for them. How do we do it? What's the process? Why are we so successful? The Governor's STEM Academy is different than the other two academies. Students in this academy are taking elective courses within the STEM Academy offerings and not outside of it. Yes, because of the rigorous nature of the courses, the students do end up in many of the same honors and AP classes. However, it depends on the student's interest. Future chemical engineers are taking AP chemistry with their engineering courses. Future entrepreneurs are taking AP statistics with their courses, and future programmers are taking AP seminar to supplement their technical writing. It's about exploring the elective possibilities before college and career, and it works. The Governor's STEM Academy graduating classes accept almost $1 million in academic scholarships each year, including appointments to the service academies. This is completed through communication, leadership, technology, industry certifications, and college and career-ready courses. Communication. Every STEM course includes a technical writing component. However, we recognize that even in the digital age, nothing can replace face-to-face communication. Every STEM class concludes with a formal oral presentation. But students in their capstone courses also have to communicate with outside vendors and other mentors. Students have to be able to communicate with people of all ages. Leadership. Every STEM course offers the opportunity for leadership with collaborative projects. In addition, each STEM pathway is affiliated with a co-curricular organization that offers additional opportunities for leadership. Our current STEM students are officers in our co-curricular organizations, DECA and TSA, and our STEM students have been and are regional and state officers in these co-curricular organizations. Technology. It goes without saying that every student will be exposed to various forms of technology, from a recording studio and photo studio to multiple 3D printers, to a 3D scanner, to VEX robotics, to laser engravers. From flight simulators to various Apple products, all the tools needed to be successful outside of the classroom are available. Our returning students tell us they are some of the only students in the respective college programs that know how to use the software and machines affiliated with those programs because of the courses they took in the Governor's STEM Academy. Industry certifications. All STEM students will earn multiple industry certifications. What is an industry certification? It's a credential from an agency earned after testing at the conclusion of a course. It is a mark of excellence in the technology industry standard. Some industry certifications may be used for college credit, but most certainly the skills gained by earning industry certifications prepare students for success in technical degrees in college. College and career readiness. Not only are all STEM courses rigorous, but each STEM pathway has been partnered with several AP classes to ensure students are prepared for life after high school. You will learn that in each of our pathways, students begin with a foundation course or courses, have the opportunity to take several specialization courses, and conclude with a capstone course, providing each student the scaffolding to work on independent projects in their capstone courses. And that includes all of the outside experiences to get them to where they need to be for that capstone course. The Governor's STEM Academy offers three pathways, but you will also see that each pathway is really not a distinct line. Each pathway runs parallel and intersects with the others, thus encouraging students to take classes outside of their pathway in addition to that pathway. Students must still take the courses required to graduate, English, math, history, PE, science, and foreign languages. But even in our program, there's still room for the fine arts, as many recognize them as a supplement to a STEM curriculum. But engineers need to know how to program, entrepreneurs need to know how databases work, and programmers need to know about digital electronics, and everyone needs to know about leadership.
Engineering is the bionic arm, the iPad, the solar cell. Engineering is space exploration, robotics, and virtual reality. Engineering is both the disruptor of industry and its savior. Engineering is the cities of our past and the worlds of our future. Engineering is art. It's design. It is beauty fused with scientific and mathematical precision. It's innovation, joy, passion, hope, and imagination. Engineering is all these things and more. Engineering.
Engineering and Technology is partnered with the co-curricular organization TSA, the Technology Student Association. Students in this co-curricular organization compete at the local, state, and national level, taking home top honors, including third in the country in several competitive events. In the capstone course, students work in teams, are given a budget, and must redesign a project to improve it. Students make their presentations to a team of local engineers a la Shark Tank style. The engineering classes use the state-approved Project Lead the Way curriculum. I am proud to say that we are a Project Lead the Way School of Distinction, which means 70% or more of students earned a distinguished or higher on the end of course exam. I'm really proud to report that it's actually 100%. Project Lead the Way has partnered with College Board, the makers of the AP, Advanced Placement, and SAT exams. The AP courses listed are just a few offered, but are suggested as a complement to the Project Lead the Way engineering and technology courses. As with every AP course, college credit may be earned depending upon a score on the AP exam. Each school that accepts the credit is different. Old Dominion University is a partner PLTW school, as well as part of our partnership team. The engineering department has reported to me that based on statistical data they have accumulated, students from the Governor's STEM Academy at Grassfield High School are prepared for the rigors of their engineering program.
Artificial intelligence,
machine learning,
genetic algorithms,
social computing and crowdsourcing,
neural networks,
and human-computer interaction,
design, technology, and research,
computational humanities,
robotics, you get the idea.
The programming and software development course is also partnered with the co-curricular organization TSA. When a student completes the programming and software development pathway, they'll be able to not only create advanced databases, but also create their own video games. Current estimates state that we will be 1 million people short of the jobs in this industry in the next 5 years. Programmers and software developers are needed in every industry. Our students are learning Java, Python, C++, and C#. Our students are competing and winning in competitions, including placing second in Lockheed Martin's CodeQuest. Students in their capstone courses are creating those video games and those complex databases that can be used across industry line. Students in the programming and software development pathway have the opportunity to earn several industry certifications, and you can see the suggested AP courses that students could choose to take as well. Again, these are just suggested courses, as there are many AP courses available.
The best way to break this down,
yo,
it's a great idea,
but
I'm out, out,
and I'm out.
I am
very concerned,
and I'm out.
Check this out!
Yeah!
Global Entrepreneurship and Technology is paired with a student organization, DECA. The students in the Capstone Leadership Development course have partnered with the Food Bank of Southeastern Virginia, and we are a certified Lead for Change school. Just last year, this group collected over 5,000 canned goods to feed the food insecure and won $10,000 for the Food Bank of Southeastern Virginia through their efforts with Lead for Change. Students in the Entrepreneurship and Technology pathway earn industry certifications as well, and you can see the suggested AP courses that students could choose to take. The possibilities are endless. But it's not just about what is done in the classroom. Students have the opportunities to take many field trips, participate in conferences, speak to groups, listen to guest speakers, attend socials, and participate in many community service events. STEM students are given multiple opportunities to learn outside of the classroom and from experts in their field. Socials are an important part of the Governor's STEM Academy as well. We believe in having fun inside and outside of the classroom. The last unique feature of our program is the opportunity to intern. Each student, regardless of pathway, will intern or job shadow the summer before their senior year. These are just a few of the companies the students interned for in the summer of 2019. And like with all internships, this is an opportunity to use all skills to find out what you like. Many internships have turned into part-time employment, and some of our former students are now working for these companies because they were prepared by their experience in the Governor's STEM Academy. Our students have said the internships have changed their lives, changed their college majors, and really put them in a direction and a path to know what they wanted to do prior to starting college. And the experiences in these internships also have given them other opportunities. Opportunities to explore space, opportunities to give back, opportunities to serve. After you are accepted into the Governor's STEM Academy, you'll join us with your parents at the Accepted Students Night, where you will have the opportunity to tour the school and meet the Academy teachers. There's a summer STEM search where you will spend the afternoon with fellow STEM students as you are all coming from the middle schools across the city. You will be assigned and meet your mentor. Because the STEM Academy is not cohorted, STEM students are in classes with all of the Grassfield students, with the exception of their STEM classes. This gives students the opportunity to be a part of the Grizzly family and learn the Grizzly way. And of course, be a part of the Grassfield community of excellence. But you will have ample opportunities to be with your STEM family outside of class too. All students are required to have a 3.0 grade point average as well as complete Algebra 1 prior to admission. So if you've not taken Algebra 1, please don't think that you cannot apply, because if you are accepted, you will have the opportunity to take it in summer school. So what's next? There are two parts to the application. Be mindful of the deadlines. The application is electronic. And while you will not be submitting any projects to Grassfield High School prior to assessments, there will be some homework and some programs to familiarize yourself with prior to the assessments. Once you've completed the application, check your school email for directions. Depending upon your first choice pathway, you will be asked to complete some tutorials to familiarize yourself with what is done in each of the pathways. Don't worry. You don't have to be an expert with any of the software. We just want you to run through the tutorials and practice. Part A is the application itself. This must be completed prior to December 18th. Part B includes the teacher recommendations. The only thing you have to do is let your English, math, science, and history teachers know that you have applied to the Governor's STEM Academy, and they will do the rest. When completing Part A of your application, you will be directed to a link to select and reserve your assessment time. There will be several to choose from, all in January. All students will participate in a written assessment on site, but you will also participate in a project based on your intended pathway. Remember, this is that homework that we asked you to complete prior to coming in. Those dates are going to be listed on the application. Now, don't worry, like I said, you don't have to know how to code today. You don't have to know how to build a robot or use Inventor. And you don't have to know how to own your own business. You will bring your own device, and you should be familiar with Google Documents and Google Slides, or the equivalent of Microsoft Word and PowerPoint. Remember, you're also checking your school email. the one you use on your application to receive instructions on some tutorials to watch and do prior to your assessment.
You my winning. It's like 25 the laps that you bust out of prison. Something's in the air, something's in the air. It's like that feeling when you're just about to kill it. Take your last shot, you know you're gonna hit it. Something's in the air, something's in the air. Whoa. They wouldn't listen. It's like an anthem that the whole world's singing. Hands are in the air, hands are in the air. Whoa.
Thank you for watching. Please follow us on social media to see all the wonderful things we are doing in the Governor's STEM Academy. We hope you will join us.